Agent 47 and Diana Burnwood are the world's top assassins working for the ICA. Unknowingly, they have been hired by a shadow client to target a number of operatives of Providence, a secret organization working in the highest echelons of power. Providence's controller, the Constant, approaches Diana and makes her a deal. Eliminate the shadow client and learn about 47's past. But when 47 discovers that the shadow client is Lucas Gray, his lost childhood friend, he and Diana switch sides to fulfill an old pact. Destroy Providence. Together, they manage to capture the Constant, forcing him to reveal the identities of the three Providence partners. Eliminate them, and the war would be over. However, the Constant has an ace up his sleeve. Look closer. In the shadows. Behind the everyday world. Beyond the headlines and the seats of power. A hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable, the unforgivable, and it never gave us a second thought until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learned the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base. Alexa Carlisle's helicopter just took off. Confirmed target locations. Over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlisle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free. And since then, he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlisle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar Al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, so Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
Right. This is our moment, 47. Providence ruined our lives with the flick of a pen. Today, we return the favor. Happy hunting. Look closer.
Today is the inauguration of the scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
47. Come in. 47, do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here.
I'm in position.
47, the inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
On behalf of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali, I bid you welcome to the scepter.
Nice threads.
A little bit.
I'm glad to hear.
And
And as all of you know, I am from one of the less primitive sides of the spectrum. Owls are his pleasure. But with a small loan from my father, I soon built up a construction empire that was worthy of the great Al-Ghazali legacy. So, I would like to thank my cousins, without whose friendship and influence this achievement might not have been possible. Thank you. I'm proud to yet again immortalize our great family name. But most importantly, this building is for all the people of Providence, which is today the tallest building in the world.
Talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. Looks like the staff area could provide you with a viable route to the server.
I think you were coming on a little too strong, mister. Whoa, easy there, Tiger.
There's a keypad lock on the doors to the staff area. One moment. All right, try this. 4706. There's quite a bit of security here. One moment. You ready for some more fresh air, 47?
Don't you worry. A colleague is also out there looking.
But this is awful. I mean, I'm in my... boxers, and you are a woman. It's just so embarrassing.
Oh, it's nothing I haven't seen before.
But you don't understand. I'm military. We military men are used to punctuality. I was supposed to be ready and present my papers half an hour ago.
Yes, you men in the army.
Open that window remotely. Scan the lock with your camera and I'll have a try. Attempting to restore the lost power base of the Providence Partners. If Ingram and Stuyvesant were asked to a meeting, thinking they'll be told of new developments, I suspect they'd jump at the chance. There's a lounge area at the top of the building. It can be sealed off for private conversations. If we lure the targets there, they'll be trapped. Thank you. us in this hallway. Let's try again, shall we? I think I've got it. We'll need a key card to gain access.
Got it.
Someone in maintenance should have one we can borrow for a spell.
To start with. Exploding golf ball?
I don't want blood on my hands. I've never taken things to such an extreme before. Yes. I promise I'll start learning anger management. I know I have issues. Admit
it. What?
I think you should pick that up, sir.
About what you said.
Yeah, I changed my mind.
It's all fine. Ugh, I hate this system already.
System online.
Waste of time.
Everything looks just fine. Damn right, you guys have stupid equipment. I'm sick of coming down here.
Partners should be moving up here shortly. Looks like the lounge can be sealed off for private conversations. Andy. Building cameras are now disabled. Elevator doors are now open. Excellent. I see the partners moving. You should join their meeting. Time to end this, 47.
No need to panic.
Partners to be alone. Then you can activate the room's lockdown feature.
Just a sec.
Partners are alone now. I'll activate the panel controlling the room's security features. When you're ready, use it to start the show.
How are you?
Where is he? Where's the Sheikh?
It's a busy day for him. Surely we can give him a few moments.
Do you know what he wants to talk about?
No, but I've known this man for a long time. You wouldn't call us up here without good reason.
What's this? Carl? Did you do that?
I certainly did not. I have no idea what's going on.
Gentlemen.
What's the meaning of this?
You. You're the one responsible for all this. Gray, what do you want?
Something that has been a long time due. Revenge.
Revenge? How banal. You killed Cobb, Navikov, Caruso, the Washington twins, everyone at Haven. You broke into our bank. And you outed Providence to the world. Whatever perceived slight we've done to you is insignificant to the amount of damage you've caused us. You've caused the world.
You're a murderous terrorist. Nothing more. What did we ever do to you anyway?
You specifically? Nothing. Providence, everything. Providence made me, and at the flick of a pen, Providence broke me. I'm just returning the favor. Providence has ruined the lives of countless people, expecting and facing no consequence for its actions. You take for yourselves and those who support you, and you burn everyone and everything else to the ground from the comfort of the shadows. No more.
You're delusional.
Exposing us achieved nothing beyond moving a few pieces around on a board much more complicated than you can fathom. The world believes we're dead. What more do you want?
Me? Nothing. My friend, however, well, let's just say he's a bit of an expert. I'm just here to watch you die. 47. Finish it. Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Providence will soon be no more than a bad memory. 47. Thank you. I'll meet you at the rendezvous on the edge of town. That's your winning face. I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the constant.
Yeah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once. We can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did,
she'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlisle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this? All of it?
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
You had me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.